I want to welcome all of you to today's best fast, and let us have a word of prayer. Our dear God, you are in heaven, we glorify your name this evening for your protection, for your blessings, dear God. We also want to thank you for this Sabbath that you have given unto us. We pray that as we open your holy word, you may send the Holy Spirit to be with us. Because we pray in Jesus' name, amen. Happy Sabbath, everybody. I know the week has been very tough. No meeting, no shaking hand. But this Sabbath evening, this evening, I want to share with you about a friend. And I believe at the end of it, you also find this friend so dear to you. I will be reading from the book of Luke, chapter 8, verses 40 to 42, then jump to 48 up to 56. This is a story which I believe most of us might have read it or listened to the story. It's about the story of Jairus' little daughter. All of us know that Jairus was a Jewish leader, and the responsibility of being a leader that he was supposed to take care of the synagogue, and another key function that he was supposed to be in charge of those who handled the services in the synagogue. And that one gave him a mileage to be a very respectable, important, and somebody of influence in the society. And to make it a bit notchier, he was a rich person. But a story is told that it had taken around 400 years before the children of Israel could see miracles. Then by that time, Jesus started the mission. And he was doing miracles, healing the sick, raising the dead, and also giving comfort to the oppressed. And this word spread from one person to the other, in the town and in the countryside. It was the hottest news. And we are told that the Jewish leaders were always angry with the new teaching Christ was bringing. And it appears as if they had hardened their heart to listen to the teaching of Jesus Christ. But you'll agree with me that it reached a time that Jairus had a problem. And the problem was that the only daughter he had was sick. And she was only 12 years old. It means, since he was a man of his influence in society, and he was also rich, it means he had looked for medication within and abroad, but he could not get. And he was convinced, because of the miracle he had, that Christ was doing. And we are told that Jairus made a move to go and look for Jesus. Unfortunately, when he went, he found that Christ had gone to the other side of the sea of Galilee to go and teach, comfort, and heal those who are sick. That one did not deter him. So when he heard that Christ was coming back, he was really struggling, because we know by then that Christ was always following the multitude, and getting a glimpse of him was a problem. But we are told that Jairus struggled to get a glimpse of Jesus Christ. And when he was able to get that opportunity, he told Christ that, "My daughter is sick." That was the problem Jairus had. And Christ accepted the invitation to go to Jairus' home. But one thing also you understand that Jairus was a man of influence and a rich person. And maybe his servant could have asked himself, "You mean Jesus doesn't know Jairus? Why is that people cannot give Jairus away to meet Christ, it also tells you that Christ is all-knowing. Amidst the multitude, he knew that Jairus had a problem. As you continue reading your Bible from Luke chapter 8, verses 49, a sad story happened that as Jairus was pleading with Jesus Christ to go and heal her daughter, he's told that his daughter has died. And somebody will ask, why then should Christ proceed to Jairus' house if their daughter is dead? We are told that Christ made his way to Jairus' home, and when he was there, he went into the room where the daughter was lying, and that is recorded in the book of Luke chapter 8, verses 49. As you go downward, 54 says, but he put them all outside. Luke took her by the hand and called, saying, little girl, arise. That's where I want to measure my sharing this evening. I've said that amidst these challenges we are having, we still have a friend. A friend who we can take our sorrows. A friend we can still confide to him. A friend who is able to meet us at our point of need. In this story, amidst the challenges we are facing as God's children, it gives us an illustration that Jesus feels every bit of pain you feel. That you should never be afraid to bring your needs to Jesus Christ. That Jesus longs to help us, and that he has power to help when no one can do so. This evening, I want to beseech you that you may accept Christ to be your personal friend, that you may embrace him as your personal savior and confide unto him and purpose to bring all your trespass unto him and ask him to forgive you and prepare you for his soon return. May God bless you. May God take care of you, and may his blessings be upon you. Amen. Let us stand for a word of prayer. We glorify your name, our dear God, who art in heaven this evening. You have talked to us about the story of Jairus' daughter. How we pray that you may send the Holy Spirit to soften our heart, to listen to a still voice as you speak to us, Father, that you may walk according to your precept, Father. Forgive us our sins and prepare us for a soon return, because you pray in Jesus' name. Amen.